Thank you, Miss Hines.
Hey, with Bobby Crack and Shaky Baby Deal, award with the number one spot, man. Hey, shout out to the mayor of Sunnyside, man, for this award, man. I love it. And it's got number one spot TV on that mug, ain't it? Thank you.
You're welcome.
Man,
you
think of three.
Thank you.
Thank you for my time.
All right.
to see you.
I'm Bruce Middleton.
Bruce, good to see you.
I can.
So you know my uncle. I was there.
I did. All right. Appreciate you. Thank you for
that.
Turn the music off.
That's why Bud and Don Massey and my oldest sister, Rose Marie Massey, was missing. Patty and Willie Massey. While we're having a great, great time here at the Sunnyside Health and Mother Service Center, located at 4410 Reed Road. We have a lot of departments here that we're trying to recognize that have helped us serve in this community year after year after year. We have senior organizations. We have a lot of the community media who come out and just try to film what the local people are doing. We have the Houston Police Department out. We have the Sheriff's Office out. We've had the Congressional Office come in to help us. Honor people, former council member Mike Knox, and others. We've got like a lot of community people here. What are we doing here today?
Sunnyside.
So KCOH, we gathered here together so that we could honor you in this city, in this business district of Sunnyside, and we have honors for you. We have honors for KCOH Radio. Can y'all say? From the National Night Out, we also have honors for KCOH from U.S. Congressman and my King Arthur, Alexander Green. Can y'all say? So we are out here line dancing. We have the Lola Walker line dancers. We have domestic violence departments out here, Department on Neighborhoods. Anybody want to, I think I talked on the air Saturday, probably about 5-6 hours, where we were telling people that they could come to us. If they didn't know if they were registered to vote, they could come out here to this venue and sign up. If they had any questions or concerns, because a lot of the seniors do, and the young men, 30 to 55, said they're not gonna vote. So something has to be done. And we're trying to make a difference out here in Sunnyside. And we love you, KCOH. Yes, it does. All the way to 9 o'clock, we're at 4410 Reed Road. We had lots of food, hot dogs. We have plenty still to eat if they can make it over here. And meet and greet their neighbors and the people who collaborate with us all year round to serve this neighborhood. Grade school, finish high school, and they had never beat Yates. They beat Yates! Yeah, we got plenty of food. You coming? All right. So y'all know the same plate or two? We got some folks coming. Thank you, Ralph Cooper. We just wanted to tell you how much we love you out here in Sunnyside, the KCOH family, Paris Seeley, and what's his name, Carrie. So tell them thank you. That's right, Michael Harris. You know, we go way back. He always tell me where the places are to eat out there. Most of the time my car broke, I can't get it. Hey, look, John didn't even help me with that. Let's go. He be saying, you can eat your car, who got it? But anyway, y'all really do take care of us out here in Sunnyside. We really do love and appreciate you. He sure is. He's here. They can't let you go on Sunday. Now, wasn't that nice? They kept me on there 6 hours there. I was trying to work. I was trying to do this. I was on the air 6 hours. What was I going to say? They are, some of them are coming out here, so tell them to make sure they got some. Lola, we had something for y'all. Bring them in here, tell them to play the music and y'all dance. We have something for y'all group. How we going to give out the money? They dancing out there. Tell them coming here. Come on. Let's give.
All right, ladies, let's go.
Let's give Lola Walker and the Keep Moving Line Dancers. Y'all see any keep moving? Or they, do they like that moving? Let's put some line dances on DJ. Lola, y'all hang around. Okay, can we have some line dance music? And let me tell you what I want. I think they were the first group here. So I want everybody in this room to have their eyes on them. And y'all gonna pick one of them for this $25 gift card. Okay?
I already got
it. You cheating. That's because you're cheating.
Thank you. Thank you. the one. The DNA check, man, I'm the father. Hey, child support, new life skills, and the team got it going on. Next week's
picture.
Oh, yeah. All the people in the house say, yeah! I know that's right.
We were trying to think of him today.
Where's
Three, two.
Yeah.
Got it.
Don't act like y'all scared to touch me. Hello, over there at the table. Wait a minute. Okay, can everybody just be quiet a minute? Eric, you're not speaking out either. Come over here. Hello at the table. Hello at the table. Hello at the table. We see you. Come over here. We're trying to get these last photos. We want you on. Otherwise, I'm telling you, Chief. I will tell the Chief. Well, Eric. And I'm glad Eric is here. These events are for the law enforcement, for those agents. Get back over here. We honor y'all. For those agencies that help us all year round serving. I don't care if it's trash, drugs, crime, fire, smoke detectors, I don't care what it is. They're here helping us serve. So we just want to say thank you, and we honored each of those departments on tonight.
Alright, 3, 2, 1.
Alright,
let's
just
wait.
Got it.
I told my other sponsor to come up here. She keep drinking on that drink. Aya, come on here. Just one more, y'all. See, most of these people don't even want to take pictures.
I can take breaks.
You definitely didn't know.
All right, one more. 3, 2. Got it.
Oh, y'all, this is what I want to tell y'all. If y'all want to learn about what to do when you're on the street and you're approached by police and they stop you, Eric is doing a training. Is it Black Law Enforcement? Something, A Association. I knew it was A, but I couldn't remember what it was. And they're doing free training at TSU. They just filled up the class they have. But if you in this room is interested, this is who you need to talk to. Okay, it's at TSU. They're gonna start another class. I'm gonna let him tell you what things that they're doing. But we keep talking about that in the senior room, don't we? Yeah.
Hello, everyone. I'm glad to see you all. My name is Sergeant Carr. I'm with the Office of Community Affairs, but I also work with an association at TSU that does positive law enforcement interaction. And basically what that is it's a 6-week course where we talk about the things you should do and should not do when you get pulled over on traffic stops. And we just give a lot of free resources and information to build bridges between law enforcement and the police. So if you're interested, get with the mayor here, a Sunnyside, and she'll forward you to me and get in touch with me. So thank you.
You're welcome. You got something you want to say? Appreciate you.
I just want to say something about our chief right here, Chief Cephas, who is a leader from the front. He's seeking a promotion to executive assistant chief. Give him a round of applause. Kind of leadership that we have on our department that is invested in our community. So I just wanted to congratulate him.
I think we all know where we came from with police out here, right?
Yeah.
We had to whip up on some people. And bless God, we there not with them, right? We see eye to eye. But no, I thank God for them and all the work that they do in listening. Because Norman, that's the first thing, the communication. We lack communication between the police department and ourselves. A lot of things were happening and they weren't listening. And so now we've got their attention and they really have been integral in helping us to really meet the needs of the community out here. So again, thank you, we honored you. You had an award for the police department, and actually your award probably was the best one to fit your description it had one of the globes on it and an officer doing this. But we didn't point it at Sunnyside, we pointed it somewhere else. All right. Thank y'all so much.
Can I have the mic?
You sure can.
I'm coming back again. Just want to remind you guys that today is Mayor of Sunnyside's birthday. Hey! And play the Stevie Wonder version of Happy Birthday. So we can go ahead and put her in for Happy Birthday on today. Happy Birthday again, Mayor.
Thank you. And we still have this cash money in my hand for somebody in this room, okay? Somebody in this room gonna get this cash.
Okay, this is another thing. Okay, who's curing us for the happy birthday song? Okay, so I'm giving instructions, guys. This is what we do on the north side. We normally put the person that's birthday that it is, and we gather around them, and we go and we pin something on them. Sow a seed into the mirror on today. It is her birthday. And she put this together. Go ahead and try to bless her today with giving back what she's put in. We can't give her enough. But for those that want to gather in and put some money on the mirror today, this is your opportunity too.
John.
Gotta go find a DJ.
DJ, please.
Come on, come on. Okay, testing. Okay, so we're calling for all the vendors, any other police officers that are here that we have not seen, you cannot hide. I'm over here. Y'all make sure all the vendors outside come in so we can recognize them. The vendors that are in here, still here, please come over. And we're gonna recognize you. We have from the office of Council Member Willie Davis. We have Mr. Freddie Oliver. So y'all please come over.
Good evening, everyone. I won't be long. Just wanted to speak on behalf of Councilman Davis that he's availed himself to whatever issues you have. The one thing he always said when he was running that when if he was to win, that he would bring City Hall to the people, because he knows that people work during the daytime, they can always come out, and particularly the seniors. It's too intimidating coming downtown, the parking, trying to find parking, paying for parking, trying to find a parking spot and all that stuff, just to sit there for 3 hours to talk for 3 minutes. So he said when he ever got elected that he would bring town hall to the people. So I just want to remind you all that he's going to be having his third town hall on October the 7th, which is a Monday, this coming Monday at 6 o'clock at Fountain of Life Center, where Dr. Wright is the pastor. Remus Wright and his wife, Mia. So you all can join us out there. And never forget that most people think you have one representative at City Hall, your city council person, which is Carolyn Shabazz. Councilmember Carolyn Shabazz is doing a great job, but it's a big district. So he wants to let you know you have 6 representatives. You have her and 5 at large. And so if she can't always get to you, feel free to call us. Madam Mayor will tell you that we will help in any way that we can, because we're not at large just to be there doing projects. We're here to help the citizens, because all of the citizens of Houston voted for Councilman Davis. And so whenever you can pitch in to help District D, we're glad to do it. And for those who haven't given yet, please give Madam Mayor Hines her due. The Bible says she deserves it. You give honor and respect to whom honor and respect is due. So we just want to pay tribute. This is a night out for family, friends, policemen, and most people don't believe policemen are families and friends too. So let's give them a hand. We love to jump on them when they do something that's not so hot, like with Tyreek Hill, but most of the time, they're doing a great, great job. So we want to pay tribute to that. Thank y'all so much. God bless you. Have a great time tonight.
Hey, y'all. What is the name of this event? The seniors got together and did an event this morning. I've been here since 9 o'clock. Went on, went, picked up awards, trying to honor police and other law enforcement. The seniors come right back out here with me tonight. So it wasn't my purpose for y'all to do birthday. But I appreciate that, because every year, year after year, I work through my birthday service. Every year, my children call and say, Mama, you know it's your birthday night? Too bad. And it fell on it this year and another year. But anyway, that's not my intention. intentions to celebrate me. I want to celebrate these seniors in the room. I want to bring help and hope to these seniors in the room. Amen. We have a problem with a lot of times the people in power are not getting out to the people who had a power over you. That's all I'm talking about. And so we appreciate y'all coming out tonight, and you know, you're always going to hear from Sunnyside. We always bark, but I appreciate you always offering to come out and help. Bruce, Cashmere Reunion Stage, but we got everybody in here. Cashmere Reunion Stage Band, Bruce Middleton. But okay, Chris, we're going to let you speak, and after you, I'm going to have Bruce come and say a word, and all of the vendors that are still here.
Hey y'all, good evening.
Good evening.
Happy National Night Out. I'm at, what's this called again? The original Sunnyside National Night Out. Hey, my name is Chris Hollins. I have the honor and privilege of serving as your city controller. For those of you who don't know, that means I'm the chief financial officer of the city. I'm looking over the nearly $7 billion budget that this city has. That's an investment that you make in this city through your tax dollars, and it's my job to hold government accountable and make sure that that investment is being paid back into your life and in your neighborhood and in your family's lives. And so look, that means working hand in hand, right, with neighborhood organizations, with the mayor of Sunnyside, to make sure that your needs are met. But ultimately, again, it's about, like she said, it's about bringing information about the city's finances operations to you. But I'm here to celebrate National Night Out with you. This is a night that's about family, it's about community, and it's also about connecting our community to those in uniform who serve us and keep us safe. We got Chief Cephas here, my frat brother. Can we give him a round of applause? And all of ATD. I see Sergeant Eric Carr in the back. But every single day, these folks are working to keep us safe. Yeah. And but oftentimes we know in our community when we see police coming, we don't automatically think, hey, they're here to help me, right? And nights like this are about forging real connections, so we know them by name and they know us by name, and we have trust-based relationships with them where we respect one another, and we know when we see them, that's a friend coming. And so so make sure if you haven't already, say hello to some of these folks in uniform, get to know them. So then, and let them get to know you, but also make new friends, hand out a hug. I see y'all already ate and drank and prizes and everything, but I'm honored to be here to recognize National Night Out with you, and I appreciate y'all's support. God bless you.
Thank you so much. So with the vendors that are still here,
Sunnyside Center and visit with the seniors and all those who come into the center. My company, we issue free cell phones or free tablets at one time. We get you free cell phone service. I'm in and out over here pretty much maybe a couple of days a week. But I do enjoy being here and being with the seniors. And I say with the seniors, but I'm a senior as well. What is it, 55 and older, is it? 60, well, I'm 61. So when we come over, and so I do qualify. But we come over, we get free cell phone service, and we give them gift tablets to those who qualify. But one thing I heard earlier is about we should get together and how the when policemen come out, they serve to protect us. But there's another thing. We serve to protect them also. When they come out, when they get to know us and see us, they can approach you in a nice way because they know you. And when you get to know people, then they know you and they don't approach you in a bad way. We're all looking to serve. And the Bible says that there's nothing better than to serve your fellow man. So if we all look at it, we all serve each other. There's a purpose in everybody's life, and that's to love your fellow man and to keep everybody safe. Congratulations on your birthday, and congratulations to the Sunnyside Center.
Vendors, Randy, 8-Man Ministry, come over and say something. Is Big Baby still out there? I get everybody a name. Big Baby? Okay, so we have a gift card while they're coming. We have another $25 gift card. So how do you want to do that, Chris?
How y'all been doing?
I don't know.
You
gonna have your folks mad at me? I am. Okay, so let's see. Yeah, we got some numbers. Do they still have the scientist sheets at the back? We'll just pick a number out of there. Ms. Ben is still there? Come on, Randy, you can have a word while they find in the sign-in sheet so we can pick a number. This Randy.
Yeah.
Randy's a go-to person. I tell you, if you have a flat, I've had 7 or 8 the last 3 weeks, no joke. Gotta keep calling somebody to know what they're doing. He's on the road all the time, but he knows how to fix those flats. 8-Man Ministry. So he works from here all up and down the road, all in Louisiana. And many of us, that's what we do. We're collecting clothes for the homeless. Y'all don't really know what we do. But I love to come back here, and we have a lot of the senior community and a lot of the disabled community that frequent this Martha Center. So I continue to try to get them in here so they can be close to me and not have to go from door to door, but I still go to some of their houses. But Randy and his group, 8-Man Ministry, they work really hard doing things for those that are on the drugs, out there doing stupid things, involved in prostitution. So between he and I and Lieutenant Pham over there at Soccer Feast, we have our hands cut up. But Randy, you can say what you'd like to say about the night out and the events that you've taken part in.
Good evening, everybody. This has been my second year. Appreciative for an opportunity to be here. As Mary Hines said, we do a lot for the Sunnyside community. I've been a part of this community for about 4 years now and was able to meet her. And we pretty much do stuff for our seniors. We do stuff for those who are homeless. We do stuff for those who are on drugs as well as those who are in the prostitution area. So we collect clothes, we pass out food, we offer hygiene and different things. So just keep us in your prayers. We continue to do this because it does get a little sketchy at times out there in the streets. But it is once again an honor to be a part of the National Night Out for our second year. So just please keep 8-Man Ministries in your prayer.
Okay, so we're gonna give away this $25 first.
Who still got they wrap a pick? All right. We're gonna let the birthday girl pick out of something them up.
Oh,
You gotta be here to win, so.
Ticket number 6240.
No.
Who's in the hallway? Well, until they come in here. 6240. 6240.
All right.
You take that. Okay, we got those doors. You can go grab one of those and the tickets and bracelets. Okay, the next ticket for one of these handmade dolls.
We got three dolls and three bracelets. You can take your pick.
6238. 6238. Oh, over here. Okay, come on. Come on quick, wait them down. The baby laughing with me. Check his ticket. 6238. 6223. We're getting them in a row. 6223. 6223. Going one. Okay, come on. That's really good. 6223 match that one.
Oh, look.
Next time you have to line dance. See, you mess me on line, ain't that so? Okay, pick a doll over there.
Oh, I love it.
Okay, we got some handmade bracelets and dolls. You can just pick whichever one. You're welcome.
Back in. Look at that. 6232.
6232.
I promise
you'll make them look. 6213.
6213.
Brady, you don't count. You already know. Come on, Brenda. Named after them. For real. Okay, so over there. Okay, there's a bracelet over there. Huh? Okay. Bye, you're not gonna get a number.
I'm gonna get out of here. Happy birthday again.
Thank you so much for coming.
You know I always come home. I'm born and raised right here in Sunnyside, and all the Cephases are still here. So, love, you know I'm gonna swing by every year, but thank you and great job as always.
Thank you so much. Chief Martin here to award for the Houston Police Department. Okay, tell him that y'all see it. He's probably gonna try to keep
it.
He will.
You have a good night.
Okay, so we have a bracelet, a handmade bracelet. For the youngest, what? That baby is the youngest person here. And Evelyn, you know it ain't you. Okay. Go present it to them. So the creator of the dolls and the bracelets is choosing someone that she'd like to give a gift to. So did y'all want to have anything to say? Sunnyside Backyard Project, y'all got more food over there?
Love you guys.
All right, all right. So did y'all get the food out the freezer? Weenies that were not cooked. No, but we had some others as well. So make sure that we take everything out because that kitchen is for the seniors during the day. And just let me know what's left, okay? All right, so I guess play the music. Did all the vendors come in? Is there anybody we missed? Oh, Ida, come over here. So I'm gonna introduce y'all now to my own personal decorator, designer. And Miss Gloria Combs, you're not going nowhere. Come back. Ida Armstrong, we spent the whole day here. We were here early and we're still here. So all of the designs from my table to your table was done by Creative Creations. Ida, Harold, and where's Donald Trump? And Ron Hayward over there. Donald Trump. Did y'all know we had Donald Trump's son here? Wave your hand, Donald Trump Jr. Here you go, Ida.
I just want to say thank you all for coming out for such a grand occasion. And this is so meaningful to the community. This is probably my first one on this side, but I'm originally from Third Ward. but moved at a young age to the North Side. So everything that I'm taking away from here tonight, we're gonna have to implement it in other areas of the city because it's so needed. Because during the time when I was younger, we knew our next door neighbor, we knew everybody that was connected to us in our neighborhood. And today that's not happening. There are so many times that we do not know our next door neighbor. And it's not by our fault, but it's by their own fault that they didn't connect with us. So if you have neighbors that you need to connect with and you know what's going on, people watch for I because we are the watchmen on the wall. God created us to watch out for each other and we are our sisters and brothers keepers. So I just want to encourage everyone to continue to just keep your eyes and look out for each other as we go throughout our day. God bless each and every one of you.
Thank you so much. All right, so we have Miss
Gloria Cone, she talking about, that's it. No, I ain't. No, that's it. Donald Trump, can you get me that birthday cake somebody designed for me? Can y'all look at this birthday cake somebody designed for me? Talking about, that's it, that's it. No, they gonna get to see it. Hey, grandbaby. I tried to call you this morning, but you was already gone. It's Miss Grayson. Grayson did a reenactment of, come here, Grayson, what was the singer name? Yolanda Adams. Wasn't that Yolanda that you did the enactment for and she came to meet you? Yeah, she did. She did such a great job, she came to meet her. But this is what somebody did for me. And they said, that's enough. No, it ain't. I want y'all to see it. And the person to my left did it. I'm not going to say her name. She is so beautiful. She's always doing something to think about me. This is Miss Gloria Combs. And look.
Yes.
Miss Gloria bakes and cooks and works and everything. And she is really creative. So anyway, I just want to tell you thank you for doing this. Thank you so much. You've been so beautiful helping me. Thank you so much. Don't y'all be jealous, Miss Evelyn Floyd. Come on over here and say something, Evelyn Floyd.
I don't want to say nothing.
Oh, did y'all hear her?
Yeah.
We have a Houston Media Source Award. Miss Ina, is that award up on the podium for Houston Media Source?
Yes, ma'am.
And there's a certificate as well.
Are they in the building?
Right there.
Right here.
Houston Media Source. Let's give them a great big hand. Always with us, working, serving in the community. We want to tell them thank you. Along with all the other media that was here today, the community media. Y'all seen a lot of them here doing promos with me. Just been beautiful. So, okay, so any of you seniors that's still here want to grab a photo, come on. Okay, so we'll be wrapping up. Is it any more food? What happened to Big Baby? He went back outside. Kendrick does financial literacy. If you need your credit repaired, they even loan you money. We had the white people in here, didn't the voter people, the CCPPI people. If you don't know, if you are registered to vote, she was here to do that. If you've never registered to vote, she was here to do that. If you had any questions or concerns about voting, she was here to help you with that. So we had a great, great group of people here, resources to try and help. But, what time is it?
8:15.
Okay, so is it any more food or anything? So if y'all want some more food, you want to take it with you? I think I had brought some extra foil. Y'all can take food with you. Hey, Stephanie. Yeah, y'all can take it with you. And anybody want to take pictures, we're going to do that now. Seniors. Where is Quincy and Willie? They must have left. Okay, thank you. Oh, here. Here. See what?
Blue!
Put that up on there.
Blue! Hello!
Hello, how are you?
Is
Bruce still here?
Yeah.
Okay, Bruce. I'm gonna check with you in a minute. Randy go. So y'all wanna take a picture?
I'm sorry.
Say she's trying to watch her game.
Okay, on three. One, two, three.
Happy birthday!
Okay.
Okay. Recording? I got it. Y'all say something though.
Oh, you're recording. I didn't know. Mm-hmm.
Say happy birthday, Ellen.
Happy birthday.
That's your mama?
Yes.
That's your mama too? That's your grandmama. All right. Yeah, yeah. Thank you.